Now, this is the time to move forward to our next panel of discussion. We have our prominent experts or speakers, we can say, to talk about making stories the centerpiece again behind the big boom. We have seen in 2020 to 2021, OTT players quoted a big smile on their faces with every second film coming their way for streaming. Now, the need for differentiated content might push the platforms commission digital only, digital first content, and this trend might continue. So the next challenge is to bring such stories or content which will create more personalization to the viewers. To talk about this, that how we can make the stories centerpiece again, we have with us Mr. Deepak Sehgal, content head across entertainment. Welcome, Deepak. We have Mr. Goldie Behel, producer and co-founder Rose Audio Visuals. We have Mr. Shreyas Talpade, actor and founder Nine Dasa. We have Ms. Pooja Rajadhyaksh, Head of Content, Eros Now Originals. Mr. Siddharth Anand Kumar, Vice President, Films at Events at Saregama India Limited. Mr. Suparna Verma, Writer and Film Director. Also, Mr. Vaibhav Vishal, Screenwriter. And alongside, we have with us Mr. Siddharth Alambian, who is the Head, Video Content, Brand Solutions, and Folk Studios, who will be moderating this session. So, Siddharth, you can start the proceedings.
Thank you. Thank you, Namita. That was a wonderful introduction. Hi, everybody on the panel. Hi, lovely to have such an esteemed panel talking to us. I have a quick intro apart from what Namita said before I open the floor to all of you. Very good afternoon. So we live in times where we are so distanced, yet we're using all of these mediums to connect and shooting in manners that we never have. I think Shreyas is joining us from what seems to be a vanity. Hi, Shreyas. Set looks very different than it has ever before. Sets aren't the same that they used to be, heck, on many shoots now the set is all sometimes a ring light and a smartphone. So no particular person, or no matter how experienced we are, can we put a finger on exactly what is going to go viral or what is going to really take the internet by the storm, as they say. So learning from sessions like these is very, very important. And now what has become certain, however, amidst all of this, is that storytelling and the script, no matter how long the communication has to be, it has to be on point. So from the bits that they were just discussing in the previous panel that I just caught a little glimpse of, while there are numbers and all of that is great, I think as a filmmaker or a storyteller myself, I would like to ask all of you all, and this is open, I think, apart from the writers, anybody can take this. It's the new game and it has new rules. What I'm trying to understand from all of you is that, are we devising storytelling differently for the web or the OTT than we did for any other platform?
So I'll jump in first. I mean, see, there's a structure, right? Films are a three-act structure, for example. There's a start, middle, end. Also, in Hindi cinema, you have something called the interval, which doesn't exist anywhere in the world. So we cater for that, your first half and your second half. When it comes to OTT, the structure of a show, like, for example, in American television, you had the five-act structure, which was made for television because you would have five inserts of ads coming in. That changed over time as well. So now with long format filmmaking, which is what we call OTT writing, the structure itself is different, number one. The kind of layers and arcs of various characters. There is no insignificant character in a series. Some might rise in the third episode or the end of the season to do something in the next season. But everything that you seed in has a reason. There is nothing as tertiary. So you have much more in-depth layering of stories, of characters. It's a much more denser world. It's like reading a novel, literally. I mean, it's that compared to, say, other forms of structures of writing per se. And as far as, I mean, these are the basic rules. Otherwise, the only rule is there is no rule because you're discovering something new every single day. I mean, in fact, Deepak Sehgal, who's here, is, I think, creating some of the most insanely awesome content. These is applause. They are revising the rules every single day. I don't think we have a rule book.
I was guess somebody saying something, Supan? We lost you for a bit over there.
Okay. What is the last thing you heard? I have no idea.
Applause is doing great work.
Oh, yeah. Basically, I'm saying, that's what it's. There is no rule book anymore. I mean, we are discovering and rediscovering rules every single day. A show like Squid Game comes and changes again the rules, something written 10 years ago. So it's something that you're passionate about, driven about, because writing a show takes about a year. Prep, pre-pod, post takes another year and a half or so. You're talking about 2.5 years of your life for just one season. If you decide to give 3 and 4 seasons, that's easily 7 to 10 years of your life gone in just one thing. So it's something that you really come from a very passionate space about. And that's what this is all about. Go for it, Deepak.
There's one more big thing that has happened with the advent of OTT, that language has become a bit less focused. That means people watch Korean shows with English subtitles. They'll watch a Korean film with English subtitles. Like Narcos is Spanish or whatever it was. But you're watching it with subtitles. So you're immersing yourself in a non-perfect viewing environment where your eyes are shifting between what is being said. So you actually normally end up seeing those things twice. Good for the platform. But yeah, so that's a big shift since OTT came. I would never watch a language that I'm not comfortable with on broadcast, even if it had subtitles. So that is one big shift that has come about.
I think Webber, you were chipping in, right?
What Sean said, that completely sums up that, you know, there really are no rules anymore right now, you know, that we have to kind of, you know, the environment has changed, the canvas has changed, the language has changed, you know, the syntax has changed, all of that obviously has changed. But the fact of the matter is that people want good stories. So when I would be sitting with Deepak, and I have, as a matter of fact, on Scam, the brief was fairly simple, that bhaiya, ek achi story bana ke do. And we were allowed to do whatever. And that's the beauty of, you know, being, you know, the present time right now, that there are people who are, there are networks who want to tell stories, there are people who want to tell stories. And as writers, you know, we have been given a completely free hand to do whatever. Which is exactly why, at the same time, on OTTs, you have a Scam happening, you know, then you have the underbelly, you know, of the northern India, you know, in form of a Patal Lok, which is happening, you know, at the same time. You have an urban Indian story in form of Arya, you know, urban Indian housewife, which is also happening at the same time. And let's not forget the amazing stuff that Ekta is doing on Alt, you know. Which typically, you know, in these larger mainstream discussions, not talked about, you know, Broken But Beautiful, Gandhi Baat, you know, all of these have their own audiences, you know, all of these have their own audiences. And again, you know, they are trying to explore newer spaces. You be in a new space, you construct a good narrative and you tell a story not been told before, people are going to watch you. The good part right now is that there are enough and more people in forms of platform, in forms of people like Deepak and Sameer, who are willing to back you up on that.
I just wanted to add something to this. Is one thing that I have noticed is in this new form of storytelling, is especially on the OTT, is that there is a lot of... the main thing is engagement, right? Because there's so much content out there and the audience is very, very restless, you know. So I think while, you know, everything that everybody else is saying is true, and, you know, there is a far more different kind of content, you know, but now we are saddled with, you know, trying to make sure that they don't skip and they don't go somewhere else, you know, which was something that was there in our training from television under Deepak Saroni. But, you know, it's a hybrid model between, you know, filmmaking and, you know, linear television, you know. So, you know, I think engagement, you know, because we are not only, you know, trying to get the audience, which is so used to watching 1 minute clips, you know, and then moving on to the next reel or the next TikTok video, but we are also competing with, you know, the big budget, you know, extravaganzas that are going to come on big screen. So while developing a few shows, I myself have faced that where do we fit in? How do we draw the audiences towards our content? And the answer, the only answer is while, you know, investing more into characters and making them more engaging. Also, the worlds are very, very important, the milieus and the worlds, you know. I also feel that, you know, the more on the OTT, on the digital front, you know, if you're introducing the audience to a new world, almost, you know, dare I say, not educational, but, you know, a great example is, say, a Scam itself, you know, because it's the most successful show. They were almost educated about the thing. So there has to be some takeaway, you know, from this thing that I had this experience and I learned something new. you know, bordering on infotainment, you know, in a sense, you know. We did some crazy stuff with Deepak called Hello Mini, which was a breakout hit on, you know, on MX Player. Again, like you said, you know, Weber, these shows don't get their dues, you know, but the numbers are phenomenal, you know. And what we really worked on is a high level of engagement. And, you know, because our audience was, we were competing with the young and restless audience, you know. So I think, you know, even if you're making a slow burn, there has to be a kind of a, we are currently working on a slow burn, Deepak and me. So, you know, but there is a kind of anxiety, or there's a kind of, again, a different kind of engagement. You know, we have to constantly keep them, you know, hooked, you know, that hooky nature has not gone, which is, which we have inherited from TV. A cinema captivative experience is far more different and much more, you know, different in expression. That's what I feel. That's how I feel it's changing.
Yes. Thank you, Goldie. I think a lot of all of your answers lead to the next question. I'd like to ask Shreyas, who's also in front of the camera and dabbling as a in behind it. How is it to play out the longer arc? Is it more enriching for the actors' performances?
I think for actors, this is probably one of the best phases, you know, that we can ask for. The content is extremely challenging, something that every actor would want to. I mean, look at phenomenal actors that have come out of OTT in the recent past. Some of the best performances, because you couldn't have even imagined. There was a time when you would see certain actors and say, ki, haan, ye bahut achha hai, kya baat hai. But then you're not aware of what the others can do. And now because of OTT and all these various series that we have, like Mr. Bell very rightly mentioned, there's a world that we create. And it is creating of that world and all those characters in that world that makes all the difference. You know, content has always been something that people have been looking out for, right from your films or theater or TV, whatever. You know, when there is some new content, हम लोग महाभारत और रामायण के भी वो जो बाण जाते थे तो हम उतनी इंटेंसिटी से देखते थे क्यूरियसली कि ये कब लगेगा कब जाएगा बट आई थिंक इट इज क्रिएशन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर वर्ल्ड दैट वी ट्राई टू डू विद ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म्स व्हिच इज मेकिंग ऑल द डिफरेंस एंड फॉर एक्टर्स यस दिस इज अ फेनोमिनल टाइम टू बी हियर नो डाउट अबाउट इट
वेरी क्विकली जंपिंग ऑन टू द वेरी नेक्स्ट बिट दैट आईड लाइक फॉर यू ऑल टू काइंड ऑफ पॉन्डर अपॉन इज there is a never seen genre of storytelling, you know. मतलब मैं जब भी पढ़ाई कर रहा था तो हमने सात आर्ट सीखे थे वो आर्ट तो अब पता नहीं उसके सब जॉनर ऑल्सो हैव बिकम मेन जॉनर्स लाइक वाइल देयर इज एक्शन कॉमेडी ड्रामा एक्सेट्रा देयर इज नाउ डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ इन बिल्ट सब जॉनर्स व्हिच हैव बिकम ऑलमोस्ट लाइक प्राइमरी जॉनर्स लाइक स्क्विड गेम फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल वुड बी अ साइकोलॉजिकल इंटरेस्टिंग ड्रामा मीट सम अमाउंट ऑफ थ्रिल मीट सम अमाउंट ऑफ आई डोंट नो सम कॉमिक डार्क ह्यूमर समटाइम्स
Yeah, so, but you know, our masala films always did that. You know, you look at Manji's movies. You know, they were all multi-genre films. There, so it's not new for us. It might be new for the West. What do you say, Deepak sir?
I think if you take Squid Game, it's a breakthrough because they made children's games really horrific. Then imagine playing catching cook and having to shoot the person who is caught or playing hide and seek. It's just that kind of. Rattles you completely. Ke, what the hell are these guys doing? Quite basically, short and things like that. But it's just that impact value that show has created. So yes, I think on the broad perspective, if you take this, the 8 to 10 episode, 12 episode does give the scope for, of course, new actors and talent to crop up. But it also gives the opportunity for many new stories like Squid Games and others to be put out there. Because the cinema experience has become too expensive, actually, if you see to go to a cinema today or a multiplex today is a fair amount of, with a family, is not a small amount of money. Daily broadcast television has got married to its striped shows, you know, doorbells ringing at end of episodes and all that. So that has become a kind of, my mother-in-law watches all of them, but that's different. And, but I think this OTT space that we are playing in the premium drama series is the one which will allow us to experiment with stories and many will be picked up, which you didn't ever expect so much off the formula to be picked up by audiences. That is the opportunity we have and which we have to grow and put out there more and more.
Siddharth, I'd like to add here. I think one of the reasons why people are experimenting with new genres of storytelling in this medium, of course, it's a very different way of storytelling, is that unlike the Indian cinema and the linear television, there are no constraints. There are no commercial constraints, so to say, which is why there's a lot more creative freedom and a lot of independent talent that's coming forward and showcasing their work. So I think this medium is allowing that. I think television and cinema in that sense didn't allow that much. And I think that's the reason. And of course, secondly, there is a huge sizable audience that is present. A very big audience base in our country, which is present, which is willing to sort of experiment. Like all of us are talking about Squid Game. So, I mean, and the 20-year-olds have kind of got hooked onto it. I was just having a very discussion with my team saying whether Squid Game is better or Breaking Bad is better. For me, it is still Breaking Bad, but it's just taken, the urban population, urban youngsters by storm. So yes, I think that's a lot to say, but of course, I think India is a different, like I think one of our panelists mentioned, we've seen this before. We've seen so much of violence, people wanting to kill each other. I think one of the reasons we've been so worried post-pandemic is that there's going to be a lot more crime, which is going to be prevalent in our country. So I think in that sense, we've seen this kind of violence in some of our own crime genre shows. But yes, like Deepak rightly put it, I think it's the kids and the games, it's horrific. It's terrible of how it's kind of impacted and how the youth is loving it. And so, yeah, so I think that's one of the reasons I feel people are experimenting with many, many genres. I think you're ready for it. There's an audience base as well. It's a huge audience that will sort of lap on to it.
All
of us were just hungry. A lot of people who are hungry for some to prove something, and a lot of people are hungry to watch something new. And I guess that is the reason that it is that hunger that is just driving us to create something new and something amazing every day.
It's also the fear of Friday is gone, right? You're not writing for a Friday where everything is coming down to recovery of a film's budget, deciding whether the film or the show is good or bad. It's nothing to do with recovery or budgets. There is no Friday's review deciding freedom. That. So you have much more creative freedom. You're not thinking of trying to create a pan-India, film which works in Bihar and here because that's a bigger market. You'll do recoveries here. You're purely creating storytelling. Also, it's a very individual experience, OTT. It's not a communal experience like films. So again, the way you consume it is very different. And there are audiences for various genres, some which we think are niche. You realize the niche is also big in number. So, of course, the budgets kind of prescribes to those things. But you have an audience for everything today. Hence, the experimentation or the opening up of the horizons of storytelling.
And two ways to it is would be that while we would like to say that there is a lot of creative freedom that the medium allows, it also allows a little bit of creative control because we're a long format. People can, tell their stories like the way they want to and write it and have a live-in setting. I think that those are the things which have kind of created, which is why this is a very new medium. And I think we're all loving it. No commercial breaks, just watching your 8 episodes back to back, binge watching. And I think the Indian youth is sort of pretty excited too. And they've been watching it for a while. And now, of course, tier 2 and tier 3 cities as well. So it's, I think the next 3 years, I think all the reports that we've read is that we are going to be having about doubling and tripling in the next 2 to 3 years.
One big advantage One big advantage I may add is that you watch when you want to watch. Broadcast television and film, they have show times, they have this. I can watch in the afternoon, I can watch early morning, I can catch up on it. That is one of the biggest advantages. You're watching at your convenience, which nothing else offers. The online
media. And our youngsters are watching it on the go on their phones. While we would love to say smart TVs are coming and it's going to keep increasing, our youngsters are the youth of India is watching on their phones. They're all hooked on. Yeah, absolutely. So whether it's Netflix or any other platforms, they're absolutely watching it on their phones.
I also think that it has a lot to do with the acceptance of the fact that there are various audiences and not just one homogeneous mass that we are talking about, which is exactly why a Hello Mini could coexist with an Avrodh, could coexist with an Andekhi, could could coexist with a scam and Pataluk, etc. You know, because you are now trying to micro focus. And my belief is that, and I'm so sorry if I'm preempting one of your questions, my belief is that this micro focusing would continue in the coming days and days to come, where you would be, you know, kind of zeroing down on clusters and perhaps trying to create, you know, specific programming, you know, for them, you know, which already is happening. And what we also must, you know, kind of take cognizance of is the parallel emergence of the language OTT, you know, platforms and some amazing work, you know, being done there. Very, very soon, the way I look at it, a lot of that would also start, you know, kind of getting onto each other's space. You know, so Pratik Gandhi's next series was, you know, a Gujarati series, you know, and I wish the larger audiences could have watched it. But in the coming days, I'm very, very sure that that would also begin to happen. And the languages would, you know, kind of join the mainstream already.
That's true. Hoi Choi is now available, I think, in one of the packs that Amazon Prime Video provides. So it's
true.
I wouldn't have to call my in-law and tell him ki de do aap mereko Bengali sub mereko Bengali film dekhne
aage. Indeed.
Haan ji. So essentially,
just add. Sorry.
Yes, please go ahead.
No, I just wanted to add to what Weber was saying. You know, when he touched upon the actors, you know, about Pratik. You know, I also think something that's very interesting that's happening is that when you are seeing now actors on the OTT, and you know, Shreyas will agree with me on this. You know, is just stripping them off all the stardom and looking at them just as actors now. You know, and you know, you're just one-on-one with them. You know, you don't have the advantage of the claps or the whistles or the stereophonic sound in the cinema hall. You know, and that has, you know, exposed a lot of stars, you know, as to how they carry a movie or a story. You know. And it's becoming more focused towards their craft, you know. And so that's another very interesting cycle that's taking place very silently, you know. And I can hear Shreya smirking over there. And I'm sure he agrees with me on this point. Because now you're no longer the biggest star of the country. You're just an actor telling a story, you know. Of course, you know, on your first hit, a curiosity will be there. But after, you know, because that content is not going to go away from the cinema hall. It's always going to be there, right? You know, so it will, you know, that's a big paradigm shift that's happening to the actors. You know?
It's amazing for us writers to know that there are such wonderful actors available, you know, to know that, you know, one can, you know, write for a Shreyas, one Sharman, you know, Manoj Bajpayee, you know, it is just the kind of possibilities that it opened up for us, because now we can visualize the character, we can see how they're talking, and then writing for them is even more fun, you know, knowing that, you know, there are these amazing, amazing actors who will be giving, who will be mounting your lines and giving, you know, a shape to the character that you've envisaged. So, it's not just actors, Shreyas, it's for the writers also that it's the best time to be.
No, I agree. I completely agree. And you know, it's like I sometimes say that it's a great combination of theater and films is what I call OTT, because you want to experiment. There was experimental theater at one point in time, you know, where only few people would go in. But now that breed is growing because they want some more stuff. They want some amazing new stuff to be created, not only on screens but even on stage. And the reason we started Nine Rasa was obviously to help the theater community. But the kind of demand that we are getting right now is create some more amazing stuff, because that is what we want to see. And there's a whole breed of new actors who are, you know, there is no apprehension about anything. They just want to go out there and do their best and perform, because that is, at the end of the day, especially in theater, that is what really comes across. Your writing and your acting. That's it. So, yeah, great time to be here.
Siddharth hasn't chipped in yet. Siddharth, would you like to tell us anything that you feel about this whole new genre of storytelling that is emerging?
Well, it's very exciting. I think, we are like a bunch of monkeys. A lot of us are old hands who've discovered a new tool. And, I feel like when TV started also, and we had Hum Log and Mahabharat and, you know, these shows that were very innovative, and there were unfettered expressions of people's creativity with a new medium. And then gradually regulations creep in, and being humans, we love to put things in boxes, and that creeps in. My fear is that some of it has already started to creep in, and that's the elephant in the room. While obviously a lot of us have found expression and fortune making stuff for OTT, but we already have somewhat of a pecking order established in terms of actors and certain actors. You know, as a producer, I can tell you with the cast what sort of a budget I can get from a platform. And there's a certain cynicism to that when you look at it, and it starts to then restrict talent discovery to a certain degree. You know, I was a part of TV, a lot of shows on Channel V and MTV, and the audiences were watching at a certain point. But then the S&P departments in every channel started to make stuff so unrealistic that the kids stopped watching. And with the regulations we're facing on OTT again, there's a risk that we could veer away from, reflecting reality, which is what I think younger audiences want. They want to see their reality reflected in the medium, and when you start restricting the words you can use and the milieus you can go into and the sort of naturalness of performances, these problems crop up. So I feel, it's very early days for us who, we've had a TV industry for, since early 90s at least, that has been there. This is just a 2-3-year-old medium. We're still trying to figure it out. But already there's a lot of pressures on us. And, I think people who are running platforms, they have a lot of pressure driven by data. I've always been against, data-driven decisions in creativity. But, you start hearing, and I'm sure all of us have heard things like completion ratio, and you need to serve the log line within X number of minutes. And the risks are still there. We could suddenly have a genius like Ekta come up with Kyunki Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi. And then being the good Indians we are, we will all start making that and you'll end up with Nagins. So I think, such an esteemed community of creative individuals, this is a battle we need to fight so that that cycle doesn't repeat in a shorter time frame, which it did on TV over a longer time frame, I would say. So for me, that's the sort of the tough part about this new medium.
As an avid consumer, I would just like to chip in a little bit here. Mujhe toh bhook ho gayi ab. Like now I'm really hungry for these new genres, and I'm really looking forward to kind of getting that. So I don't know what to do, but something to ponder upon, definitely. What if some of those TV geniuses come in and do the same thing on OTT? And I think they've tried as well. But I'll quickly move on to the next bit. As you said, the completion ratio and that lends to this question is that there is this new concept of binge watching in India. We weren't those people who would sit and binge watch, Now there's families who've sat down and said, lunch bhi idhar hi liyao, dinner bhi idhar hi liyao, hum ye khatam karke uthenge. And I've done that with my family. So what would all of you like to say about this whole new concept that is you binge watch? And is that a complete kind of attitude change? Says Ada, it is the way we do things. It's a change in our habit. We generally take out time, go to a film, come back, have an agenda. Now there is a binge watching culture and it can differ as per audiences. But the binge watching bit, what would you like to say about?
I can say something. If the Daily Soap production reality allowed it, all the women of India would binge watch every day, every show. They won't wait for the next night. It's just the production reality that stops it. What we do is we complete a series and then we put it out there. Then you have the chance to binge watch. But you put Kyunki Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi every for 5 hours a day, and once you're hooked, you'll binge watch it. So this is just the reality of the environment which has allowed it. And of course, the lockdowns and all gave us a real, kick in the butt so that we could go forward. A lot of people started watching OTT because TV production also halted for a while. There's nothing, no new content coming up. We had banks of 8-10 episodes. I mean, Weber would remember we did scam post during lockdown with on Zoom calls and trying to see edits and totally.
We shot during lockdown, Deepak.
We shot during
lockdown. Season 2 and 3.
So it is binge watching is of course a new thing, but binge watching was there when you took a DVD of 24, you sat and watched at least 5-6 episodes. You didn't watch one episode and say, I'll watch one tomorrow. So binge watching for homes that were part of the DVD culture and this, that, they were binge watching anyway.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah. We didn't have the option earlier. Otherwise, I would have binge watched Yejo Hai Zindagi. Mad, you know, I mean.
Like Friends, when it comes striped across the schedule, you end up watching 4 or 5 episodes.
Yeah.
So, you know, we are writing a series like a long film, you know. So that's how, you know, as writers, we are approaching stuff. So there's enough and more right at the beginning where you're teasing the audiences. And in the end, you're leaving at a cliffhanger so that people continue. I mean, I personally learned it from 24, you know, because that's the first binge watch that I had done. But anything and everything that I'm writing, and, you know, I have one of my directors, Suparno Vaya, and one of my producers, you know, Deepak here. We have the same formula that we are following where, you know, we are kind of treating this entire thing as one bunch. Also, you know, because things have become much more disciplined, we have, like, you know, when I got onto dialogues of one of the series that I'm writing right now with Supar, we had the 10 episodes ready. So as a dialogue writer, it was great for me to, you know, to see all of it at one go, see the graph of each of the characters, and therefore write this entire thing as one comprehensive, you know, one singular unit, you know. And that is a key change, you know, as far as writing is concerned.
I would just like to add here on binge watching is that it's a very immersive experience for our youth. And because our format is a long running format, people, get very familiar and have a sense of comfort with the characters. And I think that sorts of just pulls them to kind of watch it. And of course, I mean, we know it that it's all over because of the social media. People want to have those social conversations. They want to have sort of those, be up, completely catch up with what's been new. It's typically how we all did on Squid and all of that. I think that's even more stronger in the youth today. Because of that, I think it's, and also it's a very emotional release. It's instant gratification. And I think that, and purely because of the format, people can just kind of watch it very well. I mean, we've all said that. I think we would have definitely watched some of our television shows at a go. You don't want to stop. You feel very bad at 25 minutes or 30 minutes, the show is getting over and you wait for the next day. And here, of course, the medium allows you to watch across. And for our young, I think it's also a lot to do with sort of being up with what's been the new release, and an emotional sort of a connect with the characters. And that's a big thing, because you watch them over 5 hours and 6 hours, you get that sense of comfort.
I think we had somebody else wanting to chip in. Please.
No, I just wanted to say that Apple is not doing that. You know, Apple is releasing one episode a week. So I don't know what that theory is and what is, I mean, it's also something to look out for, you know, in that sense.
So I think their theory is that probably people, the new shows, for instance, maybe people don't sort of consume them and forget the detailing of it. Or I think I did read about Apple and they're doing it about one episode, but also they want people to absorb one episode, stick with it and wait for the other one. But I think most people, because the medium is such, people consume at length. It's so, I mean, people will sit and consume 4 or 5 hours of content at a go and completely identify with the show if they like it.
You know, strategies may differ, you know, for various platforms. I think as, you know, by nature, we are binge watchers. You know, look at how we consume the Facebook reels. Yeah. They're the most idiotic thing on planet. But once you start, you don't stop. And you realize that half an hour is gone seeing random stupid cat videos, you know. So I think it's in the inherent nature of, you know, of us as audiences that we like to watch things continuously. That's my read. That's my take on it.
I think binge watching is mostly young audience, or, you know, audience like us that is into this field, you know. But a lot of working professionals who are, bulk of a lot of the audience, you know, are, I don't know whether they really binge watch that much. They might watch one or two episodes. You know, they got to get up and go to work, you know. So the binge watching culture is mostly the youth, I feel, you know.
I feel it's the old people, because they can't even go to work. They can't even go out.
It's the two ends, basically. Basically, if you don't have to go to work, you can binge watch, you know. Or if it is your work, which it is for us, then you binge watch.
But there's this whole lot of audience that doesn't binge watch. You know, I think that it may be a, because, you know, in our whole, you know, Warsaw to Bandra society that we have, we all binge watch. So we think the whole country is binge watching. I don't think people have the time to binge watch.
You're obviously not a town person. You stop that.
No, no, apna like to, film community, you know, so media community.
I'd like to deviate just a little bit on that. My father, who's in Hyderabad, who's a businessman, has completely binge-watched Pataal Lok and even told his colleague saying, "Abhi danda manda hai, baad mein baat karenge, tu bhi Pataal Lok dekh jaake." So
that was lockdown. That's a aberration. You know, we are hoping we don't have more lockdowns. You know, I mean, we are hoping, but we are not hoping for it. I mean, obviously, we are not hoping for it. It's just a dark joke. You know. You know, that's an aberration. I don't think we should treat that as a norm. So I have a little bit of a different opinion. I mean, I personally like to binge watch, but I don't know whether people are really doing that.
Also, enough if you realize binge watching came with piracy. Because when piracy happened, you were downloading shows in bulk, which you could not see across the world.
Downloading the VHS cassette. The VHS cassette we used to binge watch.
So it's I think piracy started binge watching. I mean, it's a need, right? You don't want to wait.
And all then those happened... Pakistani shows we used to binge watch.
Yes. Those exactly. So I mean we have Urdu. So we are
but that's what I'm trying to say. That's
generation.
Us, you know,
the younger generation has kind of so I think that changed the paradigm. I mean, you know, porn, piracy, everything illegal basically changes the world for the better, in a way, I guess.
That's true. I know a bunch of engineer friends who tell me show khatam ho gaya hai kya, sare episode aa gaye hain, fir baat karte hain. Then I'll probably finish it in one go. So that's very true. That's a great insight. Just moving beyond something, and then we spoke about this a little. Have we gone beyond the superstardom zone in India? Has it? Have we moved on to the end of superstars? Can we call it that?
So here's my take on it. I mean, sorry, I'll just tell you this. So here's my thing, right? We as a culture like aspirational heroes in general. We kind of put milk on posters and shit like that. Inherently, we are a land of kings and queens and Raja, and even the government is a Raja and we are Praja and all that shit. It's inherent. It's in our very DNA. But yes, to answer it simply, it's not superstars or actors, stardom driving content on OTT anymore. You can take great actors. Will they eventually become superstars? Today, Manoj Bajpayee is the biggest superstar in India with Family Man season, you know, coming out. I mean, you have Jaideep Alawat getting his due finally. He's huge. You have so many great actors who have literally been kind of thrust into a different league altogether because of OTT. But they act differently. They don't behave a certain way, say movie stars do. But and end of the day, you know, you have your ATLs and BTLs, and if you spend more on the BTLs, you don't really need to spend as much in above the line costs. Though you do have, you know, marquee shows coming up, which are your tentpole things, which are great for branding a channel. I mean, instead of spending 200 crores in a ad, I rather give that to Hrithik Roshan and say, come be on my, you know, thing. He will record all the Diwali greetings and I can use his face with my logo next to his. So it makes more financial sense to have these shows as well. I mean, and they are stars. They do pull in a massive audience.
Suparn, but you cannot be a star on OTT or if you can't act any longer.
You know. Absolutely.
You know, is gone for sure. That is gone away. You know, genre star. You know, like a Rock or a Arnold Schwarzenegger or like Tiger is today. You know, but then they are also being true to their abilities. You know, I think the era of, you know, of 35-year-old man playing or 40-year-old man playing a college student getting away with it, although he did it in Three Idiots, but he's a supreme actor. But, you know, it's pretty much gone, you know. So you need to do your basics first. You need to know how to act, you know. And, you know, and I feel sorry for the actors also because, you know, in this whole digital way of shooting, the two people who suffer the most are the actors and the editors, you know. because there's so much footage and they're made to do things from all angles and everything. I mean, my schooling has been on film, you know, so I still have a, you know, kind of a, you know, an efficiency of the amount of takes and angles that I would like to use when I direct, you know, but it's just crazy, you know, for the actors now, you know, they're I think they hit the hardest, actors and the editors.
I think they're hit the hardest when, you know, people lack some sense of humor. As actors today, before saying every dialogue, we tend to think 10 times, ye kisi ko bura to nahi lagega. Iske liye mere ghar pe aayenge, patthar phenkenge, mere family ko troll karenge, kya hoga? So that, I guess, you know, is the worst part today, to be very honest. Because whenever you're trying to say something new, something which probably is out of the norm, suddenly you are told by some people that, bhai, ye mat bolna. इसका थोड़ा सा प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है। I just hope that somewhere we just develop a little more sense of humor and get a little, you know, practical about certain things. Otherwise, I think it's pretty good.
Before it reaches you, Shreyas, the creators go through that same process. So you get a filtered down process.
I want to jump in over here that, you know, I'm a little bit disagree with Goldie that, you know, there would be actors who are not really known to be actors, you know, or, you know, not known for their acting chops, who, again, depending on the story, may actually, you know, find an audience and do well enough. And a prime example, with due regards, is Bobby Deol, you know, in Ashram. The series has not been talked about much, but the series is, you know, it was a super hit. Bharti, thoda baad mein awaaz karenge, please. So sorry, guys. My by times all these meetings with
but you know, Bobby has done a good job. He's acted well, you know. He had to perform, you know. He was very good in that class of 83 and Ashram, you know. So he went all the way. He shed his inhibitions. There was a new Bobby Deol out there, you know. So he can't just do Dunya Haseeno Ka Mela any longer, you know. He needs
you're right. What the point that perform. I was trying to make is that, you know, he still has a certain, you know, kind of, you know, with, you know, that he can't go beyond, you know, and he still, you know, has delivered on that.
Vaibhav, I kind of agree with Goldie that end of the OTT is primarily actors' mediums. You can't have just stardom driving a show. I mean, it will fall flat. You can't hold that kind of long format storytelling across 8 hours if you can't act. And, you know, I mean, otherwise you would have a whole host of other actors coming out here. And Bobby did a pretty good job.
Yeah. So I'll tell you what, I'm just adding another person to it. I'm not completely disagreeing either. So there is one gentleman called Mr. Faisu. Chances are that, you know, some of us have heard of him, some of us have not. He was one of the biggest TikTok stars of India. Ekta took him and, you know, put him in a series. Now, the thing is, we really don't know how these superstars who already are, they're not talking about the film superstars anymore. I'm talking about the TikTok stars, the real superstars, you know, all of these guys. So we really don't know. I mean, there's still a long time for us to, you know, to figure out whether they'll work or will not work. Traditionally in the West, a lot of these guys have taken over and have done, you know, well enough. So it's slightly early to, you know, kind of predict. I mean, unless we are talking only about superstars, you know, on films, you know, coming, you know, on OTT. But otherwise, there are superstars emerging from other spaces.
So you're right. So, about that. There's immense pressure on even actors to have a certain following on social media, you know, because yeah, they need to be relevant, you know.
Yeah.
But that's something that the community has to break out of themselves, you know. And, you know.
Yeah. And that's a different business decision that, you know, if an actor has, say, 10 million followers or a TikTok star has 10 million followers, get him on board just to pull in those number of viewers. But it's a strategy that works. It's a hit or miss strategy. It's not something that's working in the long term, which is why you don't find a lot of TikTok stars or, say, Instagram stars really making debuts. They're there, but they're very few and far in between. And it's a hit and miss thing, right? We're all trying newer things to ensure that the audiences comes in and engages, not just at the script level, but also at the casting level. So that's a very casting-related decision, which it's a hit and miss thing. It's almost like casting Deepak Agarwal in Agarwal, right? In Chandni, whose career unfortunately got over the minute he opened his mouth because he's a non-actor.
Malhotra,
yes.
I think what...
In Lamhe.
In Lamhe, yeah.
Was it Lamhe or Chandni? Lamhe, yes.
Yes, I mean, there's a lot of valid points in there. We often get that as advertisers, we're told to take a online presence holding actor into the thing. And then on set, the client and the creative are just rambling about how they're probably not the right person. But thank you all for chipping in, contributing to this conversation. I'm looking at any questions that do we have time, folks, to take questions?
I'm sorry, I'll have to take your leave, guys, because
yes,
I'm a little late for the show.
But thank you so much, everybody on the panel. Bijoy, do you have time for questions?
No.
All right.
Everybody's kind of running late.
Thank you.
That was really fast.
I just speaking to all of you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, Siddharth. Thank you for such a wonderful session. Thank you, Goldie Bell. Thank you, Shreyas Talpade, Deepak Sehgal, Pooja Rajadakshar.
Thank you.
Swarn, Vaibhav, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you for being
here. Bye, guys. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.